like white water. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Selfishly want to hold on to Priscilla. It brings great pain to let go. Living in the resurrection hope of our Lord Jesus Christ, in the trust of a loving God, and in the promise of eternal life, we now commit our body to its place of rest. We will continue to mourn Auntie Priscilla, but her laughter will warm the kingdom of God. We will continue to love Auntie Priscilla, but God will now take care of her. We will continue to carry Auntie Priscilla in our thoughts, but she will be kept safe in God's hands. Receive her in the arms of your mercy, O God, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of all your saints. As for mortals, their days are like grass. They flourish like a flower of the field, for the wind passes over it, and it is gone, and its place knows it no more. Psalm 103, verse 15 to 17 says, "But the steadfast love of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear him. For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance." Corinthians 15, verse 51 to 55 says, "Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be all changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. I'm going to ask you to close your eyes and bow your head. I'm going to read to us our committal prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you this day for your precious, eternal, and unchanging word. We thank you that you are to us the rock of ages and the great I am. In the midst of our natural sorrow, we thank you for your supernatural comfort and grace. In the face of death, we thank you for your gift of eternal life. In the face of separation, we thank you for the eternal reunion we so eagerly anticipate. We thank you for Priscilla's life here on this earth. And we recognize that the body that lies before us is not Priscilla, but rather the house in which she lived. We acknowledge that Priscilla is rejoicing, even now, in your very presence, enjoying the blessings of heaven. Father, we commit her body to the earth, from which our bodies were originally created, and we rejoice in the fact that her spirit is even now with you, the Father of the spirits. We anticipate the day when spirit and body shall be united again at the coming of the Lord. And we find great comfort in knowing that we shall forever be together with the Lord. We thank you, Father, that in the days, weeks, and months to come, these realities and the abiding presence of your Spirit will especially strengthen, sustain, and comfort Priscilla's friends and family. In the name of Jesus. And we all said, Amen. I'm going to give the immediate family an opportunity to come and say their last farewell and goodbye. Funeral parlor has been so gracious to arrange flowers and roses for us, and they will place that on the casket before we say our final goodbyes.
Can we have a call there, please?
Place it on the top of the casket.
Your work is done, you've been set free. So rest in peace. Rest in peace. Your work is done, you've been set free. So rest.
The loved one that would like to place a rose on the casket, please come through. Jesus, we release our mom in the name of the Father and of the Son and the blessed Holy Spirit. May her soul rest in peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. You may take your seats.
You for life, you and me in the wind. I never thought there'd come a time that our story